Of course, I am not Gerli Loco. Well, again, I'm starting. Thanks for being here. Gerli is our epidemiologist in Dakar, and unfortunately, she was not able to be here due to visa problems, so I will present this presentation on her behalf. And what I would like to introduce you is to our first experience of a health and demographic surveillance system, HGSS, in an MSF project. Well, as background, as all of you know, MSF is in more of than 60 countries worldwide. Different contexts in low and middle income contexts, armed conflicts, natural disasters, outbreaks, with projects that have different lengths of stay from few weeks to many years. What we have found is that there is a common issue that relies on all of these projects, which is the lack of accurate and reliable data for a proper follow-up of our projects. And this is a problem that affects not only MSF, but also ministries of health and other organizations. Usually, we try to cover this problem doing cross-sectional surveys, but unfortunately, as you know, this cross-sectional surveys gives you data that is a concrete picture of very small health indicators and not allowing you to do a proper and accurate follow-up of trends, which the HGSS provides. Okay, and data, of course, is very important, not only to monitor all activities over the time, but also to assess population impact of our interventions. And of course, with this data, we can adapt those interventions and guide them to fit better the population needs. But what is the HGSS? Well, this is an intensive longitudinal data collection with an open cohort, which is followed over the time. This cohort lives within a limited geographic boundary and is representative of our target population. There is today more than 52 sites of HGSS around the world. All of them, they are organized in an international network which is called INDEPT and is based in Accra. Guinea-Bissau has been an HGSS site since 1978. And well, maybe this is something interesting to raise here, because as you can imagine, it seems not very much innovative. But well, maybe if we are talking about the paleolithics of epidemiology, it is pretty curious that until today, there are very, very few projects that have attempted to introduce this kind of system. Many reasons behind, of course. Well, MSF have done many different interventions in Guinea-Bissau for the last years, but it was from 2014 that we decided to open a regular project in a region called Bafata, which is in the middle north of the country. Guinea-Bissau is a very small country placed in West Africa, which borders with Senegal in the north and Guinea-Conakry in the south. This project that we opened in Bafata was thought from the first beginning to be a pediatric comprehensive project, managing or providing healthcare assistance to pediatric population from the community to the health centers until the regional hospital. And it was thought from the first beginning with a long scope, with a 5 years project. It is true that it's not very usual in MSF, at least from the first beginning, that we say that we are staying in a place for all these years. And also, we embedded inside this project a strong research component. And also, at the beginning, we decided to do the monitoring of our activities through an HGSS. The implementation of the HGSS has been done by a Bandim Health Project. Bandim Health Project is a research organization placed in Guinea-Bissau, that was supported at their beginning by Karolinska Institute, and they have been managing the HGSS site for more than 20 years. So they are very much experienced. First of all, together, we did the first baseline census of our population, doing a sampling and collecting from the sampling 40 clusters that were randomly selected. We were targeting our information trying to select women of reproductive age and children aged below 5 years, as they are the scope of our intervention. After doing this sampling, we did our first baseline of data collection. And from here, and every 6 months, all this data is actualized, providing us a new an accurate actualization of health indicators. That means that every 6 months we know exactly what is happening in this population and we can adapt our activities according to this. The question, the data collection is done through standardized questionnaires that are done face to face to the selected population in the cohorts, and the data that is collected routinely is related to a wide variety of indicators, from sociodemographics to vital statistics, birth, death, migration, verbal autopsy on cause of death, anthropometric data, health seeking behavior, healthcare access, vaccination coverage. But the interesting thing to retain is that HDSS is a very flexible platform, allows you to introduce any kind of indicators related to humanitarian, medical, research activities in any moment and according to the interests of your projects and of course the needs of your population, allowing you to do an accurate monitoring of what you are introducing in the project. As preliminary results, the preliminary results that we get until now are still preliminary, in the sense that we did our first baseline 6 months ago, and we have done the last catch-up quite recently. We ended three, four months ago. We have registered 3,500 women of reproductive age and a similar number of children under 5. To give you some examples of how this data is starting to modify or the scope of our activities, we can mention, for example, that despite the 30% of our hospitalized children are severe acute malnourished children, which is a quite high proportion according to the morbidity trends of the region, we discovered that the prevalence of severe acute malnutrition in our target population was quite pretty low, below 1%. We would like to assume that this is because of this comprehensive approach that we have that is providing global health coverage, but it's something interesting to see for the moment. Also, we learned from this last baseline that 12% of the children below 5 years have reported an illness in the past month. And interestingly, 13% of those children showed a traditional healer instead going to an MSF facility. So a lot of things needs to be done still regarding health promotion. 1.5% of the children were hospitalized, and measles vaccination was pretty low for children under 5, 64%, and only 0.5% of the children of our target population received all the antigens of the expanded program of immunization. This concept move us to decide to include vaccination activities in the seasonal malaria chemo prevention activity that is going to start very soon during the malaria peak season. So in conclusion, HDSS provides a dynamic view of the population over time, allow projects to adjust to real-time needs, enabling rapid identification of trends, new health concerns, population movements, allows a better monitoring of the impact of health interventions, and potentially, and in a long-term scope, might improve healthcare provision in areas where we are working through the constant adaptation of medical activities. So I would like to thank again Gerli and Banif Health Project for the huge work that they have done, acknowledge to our the participation of our population in the project and our health teams in Guinea-Bissau. And of course, thanks everyone for your attention today. Thank you.